Hello friends, we'll be continuing with the story of Krishna for today. In the last video I had mentioned about the various teachers I had along the way. Today I'll continue with the teachers and their teachings. There were teachers in school, teachers who inspired me like Ravi Verma and other contemporary artists, of course the European painters are there, but the personal touch I had was with my drawing teacher at school, Sri B. A. Reddy. And then, of course, at home, your parents and your uncles, etc., these people are also gurus because they encourage you and they find the talent in you. And there are also others later in the day, like Gopalu, Sridhar, S. Rajam, and Bapu Garu, to name a few. I'll be talking about Sri B. A. Reddy, who was my first guru at school. I studied in Kendriya Vidyalaya in Hyderabad, Golconda, and the teacher there was Sri B. A. Reddy, and he was the one who found me, found my talent and encouraged me a lot. There is something I have to tell about him, which why he was so instrumental in putting me on the path of art. He was one teacher where I studied about 4 years under him, and not once did he touch the blackboard. He was a person who encouraged. He knew what to get out of me and how to encourage me. And every other day, every weekends, we used to have competitions, and every day we were out with the drawing boards to participate in painting competitions. And there you see a lot of children paint. So after you finish your painting, you go and see what the others have drawn, how others are painting, and that became a big lesson. In fact, even after the painting competition is over, when he used to judge, I used to be there along with him and see how he judged the competitions. So these are all things which I learned from him. And in the class, he used to give a subject and then he used to inspire. I mean, the entire class was devoted to inspire the children on the particular subject which he has given. And another thing is, he was so particular that only those interested in art will stay back in the class, because art is not a subject which is interesting to everyone. There are some who will be interested in music, some who will be interested in sports, like that. So whenever he comes inside, he will say, those who are interested in music will go to the music room, those who are interested in physical education will go to the PT room. And like that he used to say, do what you are interested in. So that was his main thing which he was very particular about. And art is one subject where it's not like one size fits all, no? So he will just leave it to your imagination. He used to just inspire or spark the imagination in the children. So that's why we loved him a lot. And the thing about him is, he always used to give physical, observations. For example, it is, even if it is a something like a ration shop, he could make it so beautiful. Cinema theater, of course. And then this, his favorite topic was the mother and child. I mean, there are so many ways, so many subjects and in so many varieties which he used to give, that he, every subject which he gave had an aspect of it which he will explain. So everybody was free to experiment with that. So that was the way he taught. And he used to comment. So in the next class, there was a time he allocated to comment on the children's works. So he used to say, this is how good he has done this, how good she has done this. So he used to have exchange of ideas and all that. And we are still in touch, and so whenever I go to Hyderabad, I meet him, and when he comes here, I go and meet him. And we used to have exchange of ideas, and we always interact, and we are still in touch with in social Facebook and other media. So we always keep in touch. He always comments on my work, and if not it were for him who strengthened my interest in art and encourage me in all the pursuits, I would not be here. So my initial gratitude will be to B.A. Reddy. And the second most important part of my training was Ravi Verma. Ravi Verma, was such a big inspiration. Of course, I have seen his work in, say, Illustrated Weekly and all those magazines which used to come. We saw his work, but there was a time when I went to Mysore and saw his original works in the Jayachamarajendra Art Gallery in Mysore. There are about 15-20 works which were exhibited, and they were huge. I was just about 10 years old, and I was just, it shocked me. It was sort of awestruck by the kind of paintings I am seeing in the original. It inspired me to such an extent that this is what I have to do. This is what I want to do. That was the kind of inspiration which Ravi Verma inspired. He was such an inspiring artist. So the sheer class of art, of course that was European art, well used with the European academic training. So it was a new kind of art at that time, and the original, so which he had, particularly the Ravana carrying away Sita, or the Krishna going as an ambassador in Dhritarashtra's court, these two paintings made such an impression. It was really awesome. And if there was anything which was my dream, this was it. So Ravi Verma, I came back and I copied his works in pencil, studied all his drawings. And there is one thing about this quest which I have to mention. When you have a quest in you, the right kind of people will come in touch, the right kind of books will come to you, the right kind of equipment will come to you, and the right kind of people will be around you. This is one thing which I have always find so fascinating, that how does it all come together? See, I didn't go in search of teachers, they came to me. Ravi Verma was the first inspiration for me to attempt oil painting. I didn't know much about how to go and do oil paintings. So I started with just two colors and a brush, and usually for me, I go and try things out by myself. I go to the stationery store and ask the salesperson as to what the medium is and get, I mean, these are the kind of things I do. Get, and everything is an experiment. You'll have to learn and get comfortable with the medium. So they'll give you two or three options. You go and check out, and then you get friendly with the materials. That is how I actually approach any new medium. And Ravi Verma introduced me to oil painting. So that is how, first it was two colors, then I extended it to five colors and started doing some works on paper. You know, there's something called this oil paper, that was how it was done, and that is how I started oil painting. And even at school, we did not know much about the materials aspect. So whatever was available in, I mean, this watercolor cakes and all only were there, but it was through B.A. Reddy. I used to, there was one set which he recommended and got it for the class. That is one Lefranc and Bourgeois company's poster colors, which was of the entire set cost about 24 rupees on those days, and that was very expensive at that time, about in say 1970s. So like this, we get new materials, and oil painting was a new medium which I started, and it was this which made me go and see the oil painting, the masters. So when you go to masters, first thing was, there is this museum called the Salar Jung Museum in Hyderabad, which had a good collection of oil paintings, and of course the marble statues, and it has a wonderful collection of items. And there the Western oil painting, the academic realism and all, they, seeing them live was a big inspiration. There were very good works from the European painters. So they, seeing the originals of the masters, it gave you a very good opportunity to approach oil painting. That is how these things, how these textures are obtained, how this color is obtained, and how you have to keep one layer dry before you start over again. And only it slowly comes through practice. Now, coming to Ravi Verma. See, Ravi Verma was a portrait painter in the palace. So he painted portraits, and he learned the techniques from a European, of course, which was hesitatingly approved of. The European didn't allow him to train under him, and he sort of secretly saw him painting and learned the techniques. That was how Ravi Verma learned. So there is a way everybody gets his learning. So mine was through observation. So then, and with trial and error. So seeing many works, observing the paintings, will help you a lot. And another thing is, Ravi Verma had access to color pigments, had access to, I mean, royal patrons were there. So he had his own sitters, so the models were there. And he used the same models for his Lakshmi, Saraswati, and what all these things. He was a portrait painter, which made his subjects even more brilliant, and he adapted his portrait painting and extended it to portray historical and Purana subjects. So many themes on Mahabharata, Bhagavata, and other stories which he illustrated. I mean, he was commissioned by the Mysore Palace and the Baroda Palace, but these two palaces have the is an excellent collection of works which Ravi Verma did. So he is the one figure who is always treated with respect when you see Indian art. I mean, he was a bridge between the old school and the new school. He was a sort of a person who used both the Indian style and the European style. So that is a big thing, and I liked how he sort of integrated the two types of styles. He had good classical Indian approach and yet the European excellence in painting, the realism part of it. So that was one thing which interested me. And not only that, Ravi Verma sort of inspired a whole generation. That is, not only painted, that of course he did do deities and all that, but the dramatization of the Puranas, I mean, that is very important. He actually dramatized, which nobody ever did earlier. Of course, there are sculptures, there are in temples which dramatized, but there were still stylized forms of art. They did not have that drama element. But then when we talk of the drama element, we come to how Indian art approaches the subject. So there are so many things to learn about Indian art. I'll be going into the master who taught me this paint and this Indian art. I'll be talking about S. Rajam in the next episode.